First of all, we will open the Somatic Manager software and create a project in it. Insert a new Somatic 300 station. Open the hardware configuration settings of the S7300 station. Expand the Somatic S7300 station and drag and drop a rack rail. Next, insert a CPU S7313-2DP on the rail. Click on the Save and Compile button. Close the hardware configuration and come back to the program block of the S7313 PLC. Open the OB1, and here we will make a simple one-line ladder logic. When the M10.0 bit turns on, it will turn on the output bit, M10.0. Next, we will go back and run the PLC simulator and download project in the simulator. Next, we will set the PLC in the run mode. Once the PLC is in the run mode, we can monitor the ladder logic. As you can see that the program logic is working fine, as long the input bit M10.0 is on, the output bit M10.1 stays on. Next, we will open the WINCC Explorer software and double-click on the tag management software. Here we have to add new driver, Somatic S7 protocol suite. Next, right-click on the MPI and add a new connection. Next, we will open the connection parameters and change the PLC slot number to 2, as our CPU in the project is at slot number 2 of the rack. We will make 2 new tags and set the data type of these tags as binary or Boolean. Next, we will open the address properties of the tags and set the data area as bit memory, set the address as bit M10.0. For the second tag, follow same procedure and set the address as bit M10.1. We have created tags. Next, we will open the graphic designer. First, we will insert a button on the screen and give it any suitable name. We will assign the input M10.0 to this button later. Next, we will draw a circle on the screen. This will indicate the output bit status. Next, we will select the button and click press left option. This refers to the left mouse button. Click on this button. Right click and select the direct connection option. In the constant, we will put value 1. When we click on this button, this will set the tag value to 1. Next, in the tag menu, we will select the tag 1, which we have created earlier, in the tag management menu. Next, select release left option, right click and select the direct connection option. In the constant, we will put value 0. When we release the button, this will set the tag value to 0. Next, in the tag menu, we will select the tag 1, which we have created earlier, in the tag management menu. Next, we will select the circle and go to the color menu. Here we will select the background color and open the dynamic dialog. Select tag data type as Boolean. Next, we will select the tag 2 and assign the colors for the true and false conditions. Next, go to the effects menu and turn off the global color scheme. Now we will save and run the runtime. As you can see that if we click the button, it turns on the output bit, M1.1. As we release the button, it turns off the output, M1.1.